Hi everyone, welcome to this video lecture on undamped, damped and forced oscillator and coupled oscillators, part 3. In this video lecture, I would like to explain forced oscillations, forced oscillator, differential equation and the solution of forced harmonic oscillator and different cases. The first topic is forced oscillations and forced oscillator. Suppose a body is made to vibrate with the influence of an external periodic force. The body vibrates with the frequency of applied periodic force but not with its natural frequency. Then the vibrations of the body are called forced vibrations or forced oscillations, and the body is called forced harmonic oscillator or simply called as forced oscillator. This can be defined as the vibrations in which the body vibrates with a frequency other than its natural frequency under the action of an external periodic force are called forced vibrations or forced oscillations. The body is called forced harmonic oscillator or simply called as forced oscillator. Examples. The first example is the vibrations of table when a vibrating tuning fork is placed on the table. Suppose a vibrating tuning fork is placed on a table, the table also vibrates with a frequency of the vibrating tuning fork. Then the vibrations in the table are forced vibrations. The second example is the vibrations of bridge under the influence of marching soldiers. Suppose soldiers are crossing a bridge, then the bridge also vibrates with the frequency of marching soldiers. So the vibrations in the bridge are forced vibrations. The third example is the vibrations of tuning fork when exposed to the periodic force of sound waves. Now the differential equation of forced vibrations of forced oscillator. The forces acted upon the forced harmonic oscillator are a restoring force which is proportional to the displacement but oppositely directed and is given by F0 is proportional to minus x or F0 is equal to minus kx, where k is a proportionality constant called force constant, that is the force per unit displacement. The second force is a frictional force which is proportional to the velocity but oppositely directed and is given by F of f is proportional to minus dx by dt or F of f is equal to minus r into dx by dt, where r is a proportional constant, that is the frictional force per unit velocity. The third force acting on the force oscillator is external periodic force, which is represented by Fe is equal to capital F sin pt, where capital F is called maximum periodic force and P is frequency of periodic force. This external periodic force is also called as driving force. So a force oscillator is acted upon by three forces. The net force acting on the oscillator is given by Ft is equal to minus kx minus r dx by dt plus capital F sin pt. According to Newton's second law, the force is equal to mass into acceleration. So Ft is equal to small m into dx by dt square, where small m is the mass of the oscillator and dx by dt square is the acceleration. From equations 4 and 5, we get m into dx by dt square is equal to minus kx minus r dx by dt plus capital F sin pt. On dividing both sides by m, we get dx by dt square is equal to minus k by m dx minus r by m into dx by dt plus capital F by m into sin pt. Here k by m is equal to omega square, r by m is equal to 2b and capital F by m is equal to small f. By substituting these values in the equation, we get dx by dt square is equal to minus omega square x minus 2b dx by dt plus small f sin pt. Here omega is called angular frequency or angular velocity of the oscillator, 2b is the damping coefficient, small f is the maximum periodic force per unit mass. Now the equation is dx by dt square plus 2b dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to small f sin pt. This is called differential equation of motion of forced oscillator. Now, the solution of differential equation of forced oscillator. When the steady state is reached, the oscillator vibrates with the frequency of applied periodic force and not with its own natural frequency. That means the forced oscillator vibrates or oscillates with the frequency of applied periodic force but not with its natural frequency when a steady state is reached. Now, the solution of differential equation must be of the form x is equal to capital A sin pt minus theta, where capital A and theta are constants. Here p is the frequency of external periodic force. Now, differentiating equation 7 with respect to t twice, we get dx by dt is equal to capital A p cos pt minus theta and dx by d square is equal to minus capital A p square sin pt minus theta. Substituting these values, that means the value of x, dx by dt and d square by d square in equation 6, we get minus ap square sin pt minus theta plus 2b ap cos pt minus theta plus omega square capital A sin pt minus theta is equal to small f sin pt. On sin pt minus theta is common term, we get minus ap square plus omega square A into sin pt minus theta plus 2b ap cos pt minus theta is equal to small f sin pt minus theta plus theta. Now, minus ap square plus omega square A into sin pt minus theta plus 2b ap cos pt minus theta is equal to small f sin pt minus theta into cos theta plus small f cos pt minus theta into sin theta. Here, sin pt minus theta plus theta can be expanded by using the formula sin a plus b. Sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Here, small f into sin pt minus theta plus theta can be expanded as small f into sin pt minus theta cos theta plus small f cos pt minus theta into sin theta. This equation is an identity equation. Comparing the coefficients of sin pt minus theta and cos pt minus theta on both sides of the equation, we get capital A into omega minus p square is equal to small f cos theta and 2b pa is equal to small f sin theta. These equations are denoted by 9 and 10. To determine the value of capital A and theta, we can squaring and adding equations 9 and 10. That means capital A square into omega square minus p square whole square plus 4b square p square a square is equal to f square into cos square theta plus sin square theta. In this expansion, cos square plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, a square is equal to f square by omega square minus p square whole square plus 4b square p square, or a is equal to small f by square root of omega square minus p square whole square plus 4b square p square. That is the equation 11. Dividing equation 10 by equation 9, we get tan theta is equal to 2bp by omega square minus p square. That means in equation 10, on the right hand side, f of sin t is there. In equation 9, the right hand side is f cos theta. So, on dividing f sin theta by f cos theta, we get tan theta. Therefore, tan theta is equal to 2bp by omega square minus p square, or theta is equal to tan inverse of 2bp by omega square minus p square. That is the equation 12. So, capital A is the amplitude of forced oscillator and theta is the phase difference between external periodic force and displacement of forced oscillator. Now, substituting the value of capital A from equation 11 in equation 7, we get x is equal to f by square root of omega square minus p square whole square plus 4b square p square into sin pt minus theta. In this way, we can determine the differential equation of forced oscillator and its solution of forced oscillator. Now, different cases of amplitude and phase of forced oscillators. Depending upon the relative values of p and omega. That means the frequency of applied periodic force and natural frequency of the oscillator, three cases are possible. First, case one, when p much less than omega, that means the frequency of applied periodic force is very small when compared with the natural frequency of the oscillator. In this case, the amplitude of vibration and phase are given by capital A is equal to small f by square root of omega minus p square whole square plus 4b square p square. In this expression, p is very small compared with omega square. So, p square can be neglected. That means omega square whole square plus 4b square p square. Now, that is equal to f by square root of omega to the power of 4 plus 4b square p square. 4b square p square also can be neglected when compared with omega power 4. That means A is equal to f by omega square, that is a constant value. And theta is equal to tan inverse of 2bp by omega minus p square, that is nearly equal to tan inverse of 0, because the denominator is very large. In this case, the denominator p square can be neglected. That means 2bp by omega square. Omega is very large, so 2bp by omega square is nearly equal to 0. That means theta is equal to tan inverse of 0, that is equal to 0. Thus, this shows that the amplitude of vibration is independent of the frequency of driving force, but depends on the magnitude of applied periodic force, and the applied periodic force and displacement are always in phase because theta is equal to 0. Case 2, when p is equal to omega, that means the frequency of applied periodic force is equal to the natural frequency of the oscillator. In this case, the amplitude of vibration and phases are given by A is equal to f by 2bp, that is equal to capital F by r omega. Here, capital F, small f is equal to capital F by m, that is 2b. 2b means r, p means omega. So A is equal to capital F or small f by r omega. And theta is equal to tan inverse of 2bp by 0, that is equal to tan inverse of infinity, that is equal to pi by 2. Thus, the amplitude of vibration is governed by damping coefficient 2b, and for small damping forces, the amplitude will be quite large. The displacement lags behind the force by a phase of pi by 2 because theta is equal to pi by 2. Case 3, when p much greater than omega, that means the frequency of applied periodic force is very large when compared with the natural frequency of the oscillator. In this case, the amplitude of vibration and phase are given by A is nearly equal to f by square root of p square plus 4b square p square, that is equal to f by p square, that is equal to capital F by small m p square, and theta is equal to tan inverse of 2bp by minus p square, that is equal to tan inverse of minus 0, that is equal to pi, where theta is equal to pi. Thus, the amplitude capital A goes on decreasing, and the displacement and applied periodic force are opposite in phase. In this way, we can explain the force oscillator, differential equation of force oscillator and its solution, and different cases in the force oscillator. Thank you.